Now let us see about time module. There are many modules available for time and date. You can play it around it, find them, and if you don't know how to use them, place them in the help function and get the document. So for our example, let us take import. There is a module called time. So once we have imported all the methods, we can be accessing like time dot time. Here the first time is our module and second time is our method, and if you press enter now, so it will generate a time frame. So this time frame contains all the data of the time. It contains the year, month, day, hour, time, seconds, minutes, everything. This, from this number we can extract all the data. So let us write time. There is another function called time date. Let us now write AC time C. So this is giving a string. Today is a Tuesday, February 24th, and this is the time. So what is the use of this? So this method, like in real time, we can, like, we have a website and there are plenty of users there who are entering into our website. So we can create the time frame when the user has entered, when the user has sent the mail, when the user has logged in, when the user has logged out. For every time we will be creating this time frame, and using this time frame we will be extracting the data. Let us once again see. Now if you type it, it is giving the different number. You can see here 9872. So this is our now current time. So like this we will be generating our time frames in our website. Like say example, Google has this time frame. So when we log into our Gmail account, this time frame is created. So now let us see how to extract the date and time using this time frame. So there is a module method called time, and there is this method local time. So for this method we will be passing this value. So there will be hundreds of time frames for per user according to the action created. So now let us say this is the login time frame, and now if you press enter, see all the data in the form of tuple is displayed. So this is the year, this is the month, this is the day, this is the hour, this is the minute, and this is the second, and this is the day, this is the year, day in the year, like 55th day in the year, and this is the daylight saving if it is applicable to your country. So like this we can extract the all the data when the user has logged in, and if the whenever the user is sending a message to anybody, again using this function the time frame is generated. And using this time frame, if the user is suspected, we can get all the data when it has been set. So this is the use of the time frame. And like this we can get AASC time, one more function which we have seen. I think this is much better to read. This we can use in our programs like print time. Like we can get it into the variable t is equal to time dot ASC time, and now print the time. So we can get this into the time, or we can get the time frame into our database. So there are many methods available. Just type time dot and you will get all the methods which we can use here. Let us type once more. You can choose by pressing the down arrow anything and go through all these methods. If you don't understand, place these methods inside the help function and get the help document of these methods and play around with. Hope you understood how to use this module time. meet you in the next video. So there are like many modules available for date and time functions. You can get it from the help document. So keep practicing. Meet you in the next video.